Welcome, Aries, to Tease Tarot. Thank you for being here. We are doing a you versus them reading. Okay, so it could be anybody in your life. You'll know who it is if you resonate with the reading. If you do resonate, hit that like button. Please like, share, and subscribe. It is free to do so. So that'd be great. And also, when you are a new subscriber, you will w are automatically entered into a draw to win a half an hour free reading, and I do those each and every month. So each month, new subscribers, you're automatically entered into a draw. Also, the 40th person to comment will win an hour reading with me. So there has been winners for both last month. So Leo's, I believe, there was a 40th person to comment, and please get in touch with me. Everything's in the description box below. So you versus them, it could be anybody. You will be on this side, they will be on this side. Though, of course, if you resonate more with this side, please flip the roles as you see fit. Everything else is in the description box below. Let's get started on your you versus them reading. It is May 10th. All right. So, if there's any challenges, any roadblocks, we're gonna look at that and see how we can overcome any challenges in your relationship. Could any be anybody from a boss, a colleague, a friend, mother, lover, brother, anyone? Okay, so you'll know who it is if it resonates. Okay. So far we have for you, Page of Cups. Okay, and that is who you are thinking of. So this could be someone new that you're thinking of, offering them your love cup for the first time. And then we have Ten of Cups. So it goes from a page, which is a very immature type of love energy. And then right towards your feelings towards them is Ten of Cups. So you are very smitten with them, Aries. Okay, that is how you're feeling towards them. Okay. You like them a lot, a lot, a lot, it looks like. We have your thoughts towards them right now, okay, is Four of Wands. So we are going in deep with this relationship, whether it's new or not. You could be married, Four of Wands. And then we have the actions you will take, King of Wands. So you're ready for this relationship, whether it's new or you've been in partnership with someone for a long time. Usually the Ten of Cups does signify a long-term partnership, and you're massively passionate towards them with the King of Wands. You know what you're doing. You started off as Page of Cups, okay? So that's who you're thinking of. Okay, you wanted to offer them a little cup of the fish in it. Okay, that fish could be imaginary. The way that they think of you, of course, is loving energy with a Ten of Cups. And then you think you go straight towards Four of Wands. So you definitely could know this person, be in partnership with them for a very long time. The actions you will take is passionate desire towards them. You feel confident, you feel at your best. So any obstacles in the way, any challenges for Aries? So I wanted to thank all my subscribers. There's been plenty and many, so thank you. I do appreciate you for subscribing. Any likes, it does help the Allegro rhythm, and it also helps your energy join in with the channel so I can read you and your energy. Okay, Aries, any obstacles in the way? It doesn't look like there could be really. There's so much love and passion for you, for your person. Any obstacles in the way, any challenges, roadblocks for Aries and their person? It's May 10th, May 2023 for Aries. Lovers. I don't know how that could be an obstacle. You very much care for this person. It's divine love, okay, from the universe, okay. So it's someone that you are truly connected to and with. We'll see what that challenge is. We're going to clarify. Any advice from spirit? Of course, with the lovers, there's always ups and downs in relationships. With any relationship that we encounter, there's going to be times of problematic areas, okay, that we have to overcome. So with the lovers, it doesn't mean like everything's bliss. Yes, many times a lot of things are happy, you know, but there's going to be challenges with the lovers, okay, because we're here to learn from each other. We're here to grow. So when we're growing and learning, that we may come up with different obstacles in terms of love. Okay. Not everything is just laid out for you on a magical platter of love and bliss. We have to work at our relationships. We have to see the other person's side. We need to listen sometimes, understand different aspects of our person that maybe we didn't realize before. Okay. Because we, even though we love them dearly, which it looks like you do, of course, there's going to be challenges in any relationship. So that's how I'm reading that so far. Any advice from Spirit for Aries and their person? Advice, please, for Aries. Thank you, angels, guides, and ancestors. Any advice for this happy couple? Now, of course, with the Page of Cups, it's a very creative, illusionary, like dreamy like energy. So you could be dreaming of fantasizing about the Ten of Cups, having it all, Four of Wands, having everything, you know, their home and everything with the dog and all the great energy there. You could be fantasizing about someone and you haven't yet spoken to them, but to me, it does feel like this relationship's been long-standing, a successful relationship. So you did get the Three of Swords, Seven of Swords, and Ace of Pentacles. I'm putting them back. One card, please, for advice from our angel guides, spirits, and ancestors. Any advice for Aries? Please, angels, guides, and ancestors. The Emperor. Okay. The Emperor. This is someone who is in command, no matter where he is, at home, business. He is in charge, large and in charge. He ch takes charge of family, cares for them. He's experienced, wise, very loyal, very driven in his whatever area of life he is, whether in career or home, he's very loyal. Okay. Of course, very successful, abundant, very secure in who he is. He knows what he's doing. Okay. So that is the advice from Spirit to overcome challenges. We are going to clarify. We're going to go into your person's energy. Who is this person? In this energy here with Aries. Who is this person that Aries is thinking of? So, also, you could be thinking of someone that is possibly a Page of Cups, which is immature-ish energy. Okay, it could be someone younger than you. That's who you're thinking of, Page of Cups. So, all about love with the Page of Cups. And a message, of course, pages are messengers. So, possibly you're wanting to bring them a message, or they've just recently spoken to you about something in terms of love, romance. Okay, for Aries. So, this person, Nine of Wands, they have battled, okay, in their past. There has been battles, wounds, scars, could be in any factor of life, could be in love, romance, could be in career, could be just in life in general. There's been a lot of obstacles, karmic lessons. They have learned them though. They're ready to move forward from that. So any battles from the past, they are behind them and they are ready to move forth. Very strong energy moving forth coming from that. There's a lot of lessons that your person has learned and they are thinking of moving forward from all of those lessons. It could be relationships, could be career, just life in general, you know, having a hard time in different areas of life, but they have made it through. They're ready to push forward and they're eager to continue. Okay. Not that it hasn't been hard for them. There has been areas of life that have been hard. How do they feel towards, thank you. Okay. So they feel towards you. Yeah, I've learned my lessons. They're in the past and here's my Two of Cups. I'm bringing it to you. So yes, the love is reciprocated on both sides. And the thoughts towards you right now is the Fool, which is an Aries card. They're wanting to go on an adventure. They're thinking of you, Aries. It is an Aries card as well. So an adventure, leap of faith, okay? They're ready to fly off the cliff and just go into tomorrow and never look back. So possibly because of the Nine of Wands meeting you, however long that's been that you've known each other, seems like a little bit. They're wanting to start fresh, start something new, something totally different, leaving the past behind. Look how happy he is. Just trotting along and, you know, he doesn't care where he lands and bringing his dog and a flower and all sorts of things with him. So he's ready to go, he or she. Gender doesn't matter in tarot. It's masculine and feminine energy. They are ready to go chase after their dreams, their desires, their sun. But they love you. And of course, with that, they would want to bring you with them on this exciting adventure, new pursuit of some kind. Okay, the actions they will take, that's a lot of action, but any other actions they will take towards their Aries? So yeah, they love you, very much so. Very adventurous, which with the Nine of Wands behind them, they're ready for some happy times, new adventures. Ones that do not cause battle scars and wounds, and they see that with you, that it's a very safe, loving, secure energy that you give them. So they're wanting to, it seems so far, go ahead and just journey on. Okay. So lovely energy, Aries. Okay. Actions they will take for our beautiful, handsome Aries. What actions will they take towards Aries? Angels, guides, ancestors. One card, please, for Aries. What actions will they take towards their Aries? Their Two of Cups, their Ten of Cups, their lovers. Emperor is also Aries as well. We have Gemini here, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Leo, Sag, and Aries. All right. A lot of Aries energy. What actions will they take towards their Aries? For the month of May 2023, one card, please. Yeah. Actions they will take is they're coming in with swift communication. They're very strong. They feel strong about something. They need to say it. They're going to be watching you, okay? And they're going to come with really swift communication. They're going to come in quickly. Sometimes, of course, the pages are immature energy. So when they're speaking or doing things or any action towards you, sometimes it's not well thought out or it's delivered without tact, whatever the case may be. There is a message, a strong message of their truth, okay, which is the obstacle in the way is the Chariot, okay? So they're really wanting to move forward very quickly with the Fool energy and the Chariot coming in swiftly with the Page of Swords. They have their eye on you. They really do want to take charge of this. They see victory. They're moving forward, and they are, I would say, with an obstacle for Chariot, they are rushing, okay? They are rushing to the next thing, rushing to something different. Maybe it's a new place, new location. They're really speaking swiftly towards you about this, and they're wanting to move somewhere. Could be vacation, okay? But they are wanting to act fast, and it's an obstacle because possibly for you, you're just learning about this, and they have their whole mapped out of what their new journey looks like, and they're bringing you on board. You may need time to think about it. So they're wanting to move forward very, very fast, almost in rushing either the relationship. They're rushing to move to the next step, to move to the next level of like your love relationship, or they're wanting to move physically, and you might not be sure about that. So advice from Spirit. Your advice, though, is the Emperor. So stand your ground. You're the one in charge. You're the Emperor. So you get the final say in the matter. But they are wanting to move forward with you towards something rather vigorously. They know it will have victory. They're not worried about where they land, but they want you with them. Okay. So when they had the Nine of Wands, they're battling behind them. You came towards them in the past with, your love. And it really did make them feel on top of the world. Okay. That's what I'm getting from their energy and your energy right off the top, the first two cards laid out. You really did save them in a way, of past hurts, sorrow, you know, other relationships possibly, or just life got them down. But then you came in with your cup of love, with all your loving energy. You have a lot of love going on here for them. So I don't see why you wouldn't want to go with them towards whatever new adventure that offers, you know, victory with the Chariot. Okay. Advice from Spirit. Thank you. Oh dear. Okay. A plot twist here. Let me just gather. So advice from Spirit to overcome these challenges. I'm going to clarify, but they have the Nine of Swords to overcome challenges and Five of Pentacles. So those are two very, very harsher cards in the tarot, especially after such energy going on with your person, the Fool, especially in the Chariot. So the advice from Spirit is that, yeah, they have sleepless nights with the Nine of Swords. They have been worried about something. We're going to dive in deeper to that one and clarify it. And the Five of Pentacles. For some reason, the advice from Spirit is Five of Pentacles. So from that, I would gather that maybe this mapped out plan of theirs to have this huge, nice adventure and go forward so quickly, the obstacle is the Chariot. So maybe wait, draw back a little bit. They're saying, because if you move too quickly and you don't plan, like, you know, all of your things in a row, if you don't put your ducks in a row, you're going to wind up empty. There could be that possibility, okay, with this Fool energy, okay, wanting to go take in a leap of faith. They're saying you better maybe plan a little bit harder and don't worry about things so much. Just make those plans, put the plan into action, and the obstacle, of course, is just firing ahead. So more thought is needed for this to move forward. Not that it won't move forward, but the angels are saying, whoa, take a step back, regroup, plan for this Fool's journey. Okay, I know the Fool's journey sometimes just like, yay, let's do it, and that's wonderful energy, okay? And whether we make it or break it, it doesn't matter. As long as we're, you know, still living alive. But they're saying you might have days where you feel left out in the cold, impoverished. Okay, we don't want that. And this worried energy, anxiety, sleepless nights. So I'm feeling make your plans together. Make sure they're solid and sound. That's what I'm feeling. And you're the Emperor, so you would be the one to put those plans into place. Not that you cannot go on this journey with them, or they cannot as well. It's just more planning. Okay. Okay, what is the binding energy between Aries and their person? What connects them? What connects these energies together? There is something that's causing them to feel sadness, depression almost, or feeling depressed sometimes at night. And sometimes when we do have feelings of depression, running away from anything that's causing that is something we sometimes do just to escape whatever we're needing to deal with, our feelings, emotions, the environment possibly. So instead of just rushing forth on a fool's journey, like I said, there is though something with your person that's causing them anxiety, worry, sleepless nights, feeling left out in the cold. From there, they just want to move away from that very quickly. And so drawing back and really dealing with the emotions, if there is anxieties or depression, dealing with those emotions first, because we don't want to feel like we're stuck in the Nine of Swords energy or the Five of Pentacles as well. So having a look at what's causing the anxiety would be beneficial, and then making a plan. Okay, because we don't want to run away from our feelings and run away from life, because we can't. Wherever we go, there we are. So the binding forces between you are there is Five of Cups, which is sadness, loss, grieving, crying over spilt milk. So these are things that we're sad about. These are things that make us sad, possible relationships because of the cups that have spilt over. So your energy is on point with love, desire, passion, Ten of Cups, beautiful. So, home to celebrate, a lot of love here with the lovers, the Emperor. There is sadness and loss, and that's what's connecting you both right now in May. Possibly they haven't shared this with you because your energy is so loving and open, and there seems to take charge in another direction. We'll clarify for you. So okay, so that's what's binding you together is fear, loneliness, sadness, loss, regret in terms of love. Okay, but there's still, a lot going on with your person in terms of sleepless nights and sadness. So maybe you don't realize that your person has been feeling sad. Okay, but it's what connects you. So maybe talking about that. Okay. And I will dive deeper with clarifications. Okay, what does Aries want to see happen in this partnership? King of Pentacles, security, abundance, strong partnership, very, very strong home, secure home, one that offers health, wealth, abundance. Okay, that is what you want to see happen. That's what you're all about right now. It's King of Pentacles. And also King of Wands, very passionate, very loyal to building a secure home. Okay, so maybe there's something that happened. Of course, with the Nine of Wands and the Nine of Swords, there has been times where your person has felt left out in the cold. We'll see more about that. Okay, what does Aries person want to see happen in this partnership? In this union, what does Aries person want to see happen? So you have a lot of strong energy, okay, and they're feeling sorrow, conflicted, okay. Okay, so what they're wanting to see happen is the Hermit, okay. So going within, being their own wise counsel, looking within, looking at things internally, making adjustments, making rational solutions to anything that they're going through internally, looking at any conflict, anxiety, anxiousness, sleepless nights. They're gonna do that. That is what, even though they're wanting to go out on this fool's journey, they're wanting to rush ahead, rushing too much towards these goals that we have, if there's many goals in life, of course, wanting to achieve it. It looks like they're very much, their mind is there, but their heart is not yet. And they have a lot that they want to do with you in terms of life, you know, adventures, happy times. They know, though, at the end of the day, that even though they want to charge forward, they want to maybe leave this past behind that's been jaded of some kind for them. They know that they cannot do that, and it's causing them worry. It's causing them strain. They're needing to go within with the hermit and look at different aspects of yourself, themselves, yourself, look at different aspects of life and come up with new conclusions, different conclusions, drawing on the energy to understand where they are, where they need to be, because rushing away and leaving behind just, you know, sadness, you're going to take it with you. They're going to take it with you. And that's what they're realizing. Is that even though I want to do so much and grow with my Aries and love my Aries in all sorts of ways, I know I need to go within and deal with the circumstances that has caused me to feel sadness, loss with the Five of Cups. So that's their final answer, is I'm just going to look within right now instead of like jetting off, okay, because it was rather immature energy coming towards you. I want to, you know, do this, do that. Let's go. Forget about our problems. Leave them behind. They realize that their problems, if there are any, or what they are, they're needing to decipher that and, yeah, counsel themselves on it. So they're going to be looking within. So if you find that your person is not going out as much, they don't feel like it, you know, they want to stay in, secluded, isolated for a little bit, they're really just relearning aspects of their life to help propel them forward with you. So they're needing to take a step back to look at those aspects of what's really, really bothering them, what's nagging them, what's like really pulling at the seams. They're needing to figure that out. And you're just going to be secure in your ways, and you're going to give them solid ground in order for them to have this. And it could offer a spiritual awakening. It could offer many times when we sit with our sadness, we sit with our grievances, we feel them fully, we're able to not overcome. I won't say like we always overcome every single sadness. You know, there's always some things in our life that have caused sadness. I'm not saying like they just forget about it, but here they were just wanting to just fly off and forget everything that, you know, and just boom. All right. But they're now setting back, and maybe you did have a talk with them, because the advice from spirit is, you know, stand your ground, be firm. They need to really look at themselves and see what's going on. So what is the final outcome? Okay, protection, self-protection, a little bit of defensiveness, okay? They may be, or you may be defensive after all of this swirls of heavy energy that they're needing to deal with. They or you, I'm thinking them, will come up knowing that they're protected. They know how to protect themselves from the Nine of Wands, the Nine of Swords, Five of Pentacles. They are going to feel totally protected in this. Whatever it is, the sadness and loss they're dealing with, they're going to feel a sense of protection. And it could be coming from you, because you do have the Queen of Pentacles, or the King of Pentacles. So you talk some sense into them when they're wanting to go on that chariot ride. And you say, look, I'm in it to win it too. But there's some aspects that we're needing to deal with. And we need to look at, you know, some energies here. And then we can move forward. Okay, so... So they're going to have this total self-protection, which is like healthy boundaries. They could go within and just say, okay, you know what? I can protect myself through anything. I've been through the worst. You know, now at least I know how to protect myself from these harsher energies. Okay. So I'm going to clarify with the unknown tarot, the wild unknown tarot. So I'm going to clarify on their side first. Nine of Wands. Why is the Nine of Wands here for their person? You have nothing but loving energy, Aries, and you're very astute in your, you know, knowing and your capacity to take charge and, you know, be offering that structure, balance, very balanced energy you have. Okay, Nine of Wands for Aries person, please. Clarifying. Why is the Nine of Wands here? Okay, so they were holding on. This could be in the past, of course, is how I'm reading some of their energy. Four of Pentacles, so holding on to something too tightly, whatever that was. Could be a person, karmic relationship, possibly. Could be something they were holding on that meant something that very much to themselves. Whatever that was, the Nine of Wands, the battling. They were holding on too tightly to something, which caused some sort of battle. Okay. Not wanting to let something go. But of course, with the Nine of Wands, they have had to let that go. Even though they've endured battle scars, things that have hurt them. But they are ready to charge for it. And they are stronger for it. Okay. And the Fool here. What is the Fool here for Aries person? Thank you. Again, the Five of Pentacles. So, double confirmation. If they decided to go on this fool's journey, which is so exciting to them, that it's not a good idea. Five of Pentacles twice. I was clarifying the Fool there. And also, the Five of Pentacles was right underneath the fool's journey. So, going off on adventure, not the right time. All right, double confirmation. We don't want the Five of Pentacles happening because we go on a fool's journey with just like a handbag. All right. So hopefully this helps you or your person deciding different aspects of life and what journeys to take and how to sit back and reflect and, you know, take care of each other. It looks like you got both care for each other. They've gone through some things. Okay. Clarifying. Nine of Swords, that was. Clarifying the Nine of Swords energy here for Aries person. This is the advice from Spirit. Saying stop and think. All right. Nine of Swords for Aries person. Why is the Nine of Swords here for Aries person? Well, it's nice that you make them feel, you know, inflated with love that they want to charge forward, but drawing in the energy, knowing it's not the right time. And it may not be the right time for financial reasons or just because there is a sense of sadness and loss that they may need to deal with. And they're needing you by their side throughout. Okay, why is the Nine of Swords here, please, for Aries person? Right. Eight of Cups. So all this energy after the Chariot, moving on, leaving something behind, wanting to leave behind, not the Two of Cups, not the Ten of Cups, not you, but wanting to leave behind an energy that they're needing to deal with. And that was clarifying the Nine of Swords. So something in their life has caused them to feel unhappy. I'm not sure if it's something to do with family, or maybe something that they were trying to achieve on a fool's journey and it didn't work out. But something has caused them grief, sadness, wanting to like just leave the situation, leave the scene. Okay. Was their idea? The advice from Spirit's like, no. But they are wanting to move forward, very much so. Okay. Why the Five of Cups, the energy between these two, Aries and their person? Why is the Five of Cups here? For Aries and their person. Where you feel so assured and strong in your conviction for your love for this person and your home, they're going through a moment of despair. So why the Five of Cups that is connecting these two energies? Why is the Five of Cups here? Please, angels, guides, ancestors. One card, please, for Aries and their person. The Five of Cups. Why is the Five of Cups here? I was ready to go thinking that their journey was like perfect. Perfect idea. Okay. Why is the Five of Cups here? I don't feel that they're wanting to leave you behind. It's nothing to do with your relationship. It's something to do with them, their karmics from the past, something of loss that they are feeling. Okay, so what's clarifying the Five of Cups is the Empress. Okay, we have the Emperor and the Empress, Aries energy. They're feeling sadness and loss over an Empress. Okay. Gender doesn't matter in tarot. It's the nurturing quality. Possibly, there's been someone in their life, a female, who may have left them somehow. Okay, and they're feeling that grief, that sadness, that loss with that Empress, whoever that Empress is to them. But you both feel that energy, both of you, of the Five of Cups. Something to do with an Empress, which is mother energy, nurturing, caring, giving, very fruitful, successful, wise. Okay. So they're feeling sadness and loss, both you and they are. And they're wanting to just forget it all, leave it all behind, not think of it ever again. But they realize that they need to deal with this emotion of whatever leaving the Empress is. I'm going to clarify one more. Why is the Empress here? Why is the Empress here? Possibly that if they do move forward and choose to move forward on, you know, with the Chariot, they will feel more sadness and loss, wherever that place may be. So just But the angel's advice is no. Don't go. Why is the Empress here? Why is the Empress here? Why the Empress? For Aries and their person. Why is the Empress here? Four of Cups. So bored in love, bored with what they see around them, possibly not looking at the love that's surrounding them. There's a lot of love surrounding them that for some reason with all of these energies back to back, okay, they're not able to see the love that's surrounding them, possibly the love that you have for them, which is over and above with how you feel towards them. Okay, so we have that for you as well. Cover this card as well. Can't see it. Okay, a lot of love, a lot of passion. You give them a very strong foundation, but this is how they're feeling. Very sad. And then the Four of Cups. More sadness. So a lot of grief. A loss. Another one. Again. So right now they're going through a hard time. Something to do with an Empress. And what clarified that was the Four of Cups. So not looking at the love around them. Okay. So I'm sorry if your person is going through a hard time, but you are there, it looks like very much so, to help them through this. Okay, we're going to clarify the Seven of Wands. Seven of Wands, which is the best possible outcome for both you and them. Now, I hope that through this, you don't And they do not become so protective and defensive in their energy because you're so outpouring with your love. Why is the Seven of Wands here? Why the Seven of Wands? But you're both feeling the sadness and loss. It's what's connecting you. They're dealing with it rather, it's a challenge for them. Okay. So they're defensive because, yeah, the final outcome going forth is a tower moment. So something surprises you or them or both of you. Tower moment. So it catches you both off guard, okay? Knocks you off your feet. Five, or no, sorry, Ten of Wands, too much work, okay? Feeling a heavy, heavy burden. So we have the final outcome is defensive energy, a tower moment, something chaotic, something that surprises both you and them, knocks you both off your feet. And then we have the Ten of Wands. So a heavy, heavy burden for you or them, okay, that you're feeling. And but then we have again the Mother of Pentacles. So very strong feminine energy. Gender doesn't matter, but a feminine energy, feeling some sort of loss, sadness, a heavy burden somewhere around an Empress and Mother of Pentacles, which is Queen of Pentacles. Okay, so at the bottom of the deck, what you don't see coming is Knight of Wands. So someone coming in, charging in, wanting to mix things up with passionate desire, someone coming forth, could be in the family, someone coming towards you both, offering a lot of passion, dreams, desires, a lot of fiery, passionate energy. So I'm going to draw some oracle cards for you and your person. Keepers of the Light, which is one of my new favorites. Okay, for this energy, what is some advice for Aries and their person? I'm sorry, what sadness is and the loss and any anxiousness and feelings of, grief. But what will help your person is going within, finding that solitude, those times to just go within and, really think about and feel their emotions. Like try to decipher the different areas of sadness and loss. It does really help if we can even just sit there with our emotions, not try to push them away. Forget that they're there, but to actually sit with them with any grievances and actually like feel them all the way through. Advice for Aries and their person. What would you like to say to Aries and their person, keepers of the light? Okay, the divine director, intervention and purpose. Divine intervention is occurring. Know that you are being guided. Happiness is your purpose. And we have Lady Nada, heart awakening, awakening to acceptance and divine love, give and receive in balance. Okay. Okay. I'm going to pull from Angel Answers. For you and your person. So, from what I got from one of those cards is happiness is your person, is your purpose. There will be happy times ahead if they're going through a difficult period. They're holding on tightly to someone, something, someplace. Anything for Aries and their person and angel ancestors? Within the next few months, improving health, okay? Yes. Exclamation point. So double yes. Then we have big happy changes. Okay. So there's light at the end of the tunnel. There is. And there's a light within once your person goes within and puts that light within and just recharges, you know, rethinks, reevaluates, concludes, draws, you know, different areas, different ideas, thoughts, able to heal, about healing, big happy changes, okay? And yes, exclamation point. If you or your person, your Aries or crosswatcher, had a question, then the answer is yes. If you've been resonating with some sort of curiosity that you've been wanting to know, the answer is yes. Exclamation point. Okay. I hope that helped. The biggest thing I see here is the hermit energy. And on your side, the biggest thing is the king of pentacles. So be that strong partner that you are. And, you know, they will get through this, whatever sadness this is. But that was a lot of, that's a lot. Like, that's very much a lot. They may not be talking to you about this. Okay. If they have not spoken about their sadness, please know that they are feeling sadness, loss at this time. They want to go on a fool's journey. Definitely no is the answer. Emperor, you drew the emperor. So the answer would be no to that. That's advice from your angels. Of course, you have free will. You both can do whatever you like. Okay, so I will see you next time. Please hit that like button. It really does help the channel grow. And I hope this reading has helped. If it resonated, of course, hit the like button and subscribe. You're entered into a contest when you do. And I will see you next time on Tease Tarot. Aries, thanks for watching.